Hey, everybody, and welcome to this week's episode of the DVC Show. I am Paul, your host this week, and I'm joined at the table by my lovely wife, Amy Krieger.
Hello.
Sales associate with the DVC Resale Market, Danny Metzger.
Hi there.
And also sales associate with DVC Resale Market, Linda Smith.
Hey, everyone.
And back in the production nook, and we're not going to just keep him quiet this week, the lovely Craig Williams.
Ahoy, hoy.
Thank you all for joining us and tuning in to the DVC Show. As always, if you love the content that we produce here at DVC Fan, please show some love for our sponsors over at the world of DVC. DVC Resale Market, where if you're looking to buy or sell a Disney Vacation Club contract, they're going to be able to help you out. Monera Financial will be able to help you with financing that DVC purchase. And then DVC Rental Store, where if you're looking to try before you buy, rent some points for a fraction of the cost than it would be than going direct through Disney. You can do that with us. Or also, if you're a member not using all your points this year, looking for some extra cash, you can rent out your points as well at the DVC rental store. So please show some love for our sponsors. This week's topic is kind of a little bit of a fun one that I thought we could discuss, which is DVC for everyone? We've already had a little bit of a conversation here in the room about Disney Vacation Club, but I think I will get this started with something that I mentioned a couple minutes ago to all of us, which is that I feel like DVC at some point is for everyone. It's just finding that right point in your life where it might make sense. You may never get to that point, but I think people maybe are too dismissive of it at the point in which maybe it is for them, versus just being open to the concept of Disney Vacation Club. Because if you are someone that loves Disney and Disney travel, then there's no reason why you wouldn't want to potentially invest in that travel over the course of your life, knowing that you're going to come back here again and again and again. And I say here, but there's also multiple other places that you can go when it comes to Disney Vacation Club. And I think it's good to start with us, you know. When it came to Disney Vacation Club, we didn't think it was for us.
You've got me, like, I feel like a deer in the headlights, because I was not expecting you to say it was for everybody at some point in time. Because now I'm, like, going in my head, I'm like, okay, it's not for my dad. It's not for, you know, but...
A Disney fan.
Okay, a Disney fan.
People that come to Disney. No, not the person that travels to Wyoming and vacations in Wyoming every year. Probably not for you, I'm sorry. But I think people that are listening to this or that have, like, come to Disney and seen a DVC booth at some point in their life and been like, it was me. Like, I was that person that just sort of shrugged it off. And yet here I am years later working and selling and all that kind of fun stuff.
When it comes to Disney fans, people who like to go to Disney year after year after year, I think Disney Vacation Club can be for a lot of them. But I still think that there are people that it does not fit with. And those are people that maybe... they don't really care about the resort they're staying in. They look at their hotel as, you know, this is where I sleep at night. And as long as it's clean and safe, then I want the best deal possible because I'm spending all day in the parks. It does not matter where I stay. And those types of people, if they're even staying on property at all, are probably going to be happier staying at, like, you know, like the value resorts. And those, I think those still kind of remain lower price than DVC. But if you are like we were and you stayed in, like, moderate level resorts, you came, you know, often, multiple times a year, or at least consistently every single year, then it's definitely worth considering buying DVC. But I don't think it is for every single Disney fan out there.
I genuinely love this topic. And I know that might seem weird because like Paul just said, I literally sell Disney Vacation Club. But my favorite part about my job is that I get to genuinely build connections and relationships with my clients and my members and be that, like, counselor for you, right? And so I love when I'm talking to a family and getting to know the family. And, you know, I could say to you, it might not be a good fit for you at this time. But I think it's all about why and understanding why. And again, like Paul said, just because it's not a good fit for you right now at this point in your life, the way that you're vacationing, doesn't necessarily mean it's never going to be a good fit for you. It's just understanding why and when. And so just to give you some examples of like someone who I would literally, they would come to me, ask about DVC, and I would literally tell them, this is not for you. Like, kind of a jolting thing to hear from a person who literally is selling you DVC. So if you are the type of family that you come to Disney once every 5 or 10 years, DVC is not for you yet. Now, renting points might be a really good option for you to get your feet wet. Or maybe this is like your first or second Disney trip ever. And you're like, okay, I like this, but I'm not sure if I'm going to do it enough. Start with DVC rental store and, you know, rent those points, get your feet wet, see if it's going to be something that you even like to do. But again, DVC is not for the family who does not do Disney trips. So if you like every year you do an international trip and you, you know, have this goal to see all the countries in the world, it might not be a good fit for you right now. So that's just one of the many.
Well, and I like the point you brought up about rental as well, because it does make it attainable to those people, to your point, Amy, that don't care where they stay necessarily, because those people that are staying in a moderate level property, or in some cases, even a value level property, those prices that you're paying, it can be attainable to get a DVC resort on the rental market for that price. And so now you're staying in an even better accommodation. You know, you don't care where you're going to stay or anything like that. So you're staying in that property that is so much nicer now. And that probably gets some wheels turning when it comes to the product and what Disney Vacation Club is. And I think you can't ignore the fact that I can't tell you, maybe Art of Animation was the last full-blown resort that they've built since Disney Vacation Club has been around that's not had DVC associated with it. I know they added on the tower, the Grand Destino Tower at Coronado, but like for them, even Disney itself, they're acknowledging that there's value in this product. And so it should make you kind of question, this DVC thing maybe is something I should look into and not dismiss.
Also, it doesn't have to be all or nothing either. Like, yeah. I literally just got done traveling around the entire world. I went to 20 different countries. And so was Disney every trip that I took? Of course not. So you could do a combination of the two. It doesn't mean that every trip you ever have to do from here on out has to be at Disney. So, you know, when I was looking at DVC, when I purchased, it was like, is a 500 point package going to be right for me right now at this point? No. So I started lower. I still do my international trips, but I also get my Disney trips in there as well. So there are other alternatives as well.
And I think you have to step back and really consider the person that you're speaking to, or that, you know, in our case years ago or on the ships or what have you, that's sitting in front of us, and find out what's important to that person. Are they there investigating you, and did they come to see you, or did they call you up or reach out to you because they're curious? Did they reach out to you because there is that family time that's very, very important to them? And I learned a long time ago, and I'll try and make it a quick story, is that when I was in Vero Beach, the grand opening team way back when, a very distinguished gentleman came to see me. And he was considerably older, quite well off. He was a retired banker on Wall Street, and they had a beautiful home in Vero Beach. And he was in the resort with me, and he came to look at Disney Vacation Club. And he brought in a pad of paper, and he had a billion questions about it. And we sat there, and we went through his questions, and I was starting to think, you know, this is just not going to be probably for this gentleman some of the questions he's asking me. But the more we talked together, the more I realized what was really important to him. It was the family time. And he said, Linda, I've got 4 adult children. I've got 11 grandkids, and I can't get them all together. I can give them money. I can give them money when I retire. I'm perfectly comfortable doing that, but they'll just go blow it on something else. But if I could give him a gift of a vacation and bring us together, even every so many years, to me, that's what I want to do. So see, it wasn't him that was really going to use the membership the most. it was the family that was going to use the membership the most. And do you know, the very next year, he brought 17 people down for Thanksgiving, and they went to Disney World. 17 people. The youngest one was just an infant. And then they came over to Vero Beach and finished off the vacation, and they had the beach cottage, and the wife was let in because she wanted to cook the turkey. That was her family tradition. So I think the value of Disney Vacation Club has many different meanings to different people. You can be a Disney person and do nothing but go to the parks. You can be somebody like me that bought in, that used it, but loved to go skiing in Colorado with it. That was very important to me. You went around the world, you could probably sit down and check off a couple of those countries you could use your points at. Mm. So I think, you know, I'm being honest now, I've only told one person in all my years, this is not for you. And they didn't take it very well. That was like my first couple years. I said,
yeah, they don't like to hear it.
They're like, why would you tell us that? And I said, well, just kind of the questions and answers that were going through. And do you know that in 6 months later, they called back and they did buy. They bought a small package to try it out. So there's going to be, and there's nothing wrong with those people that come and look at it. They're curious. They get all the facts. You've spent the time. You've done your job. And for whatever reason, they make that decision. But you know what? That's fine, because they may go tell their friends or someone in their family, I think this might be for you. Here's Linda's card. Here's Danny's card. Why don't you reach out to them? You know, you never know how it's going to touch people.
You brought something up that kind of triggered a thought. And you know who DVC is for, who they think that it's not for? Workaholics.
Oh, yeah. This will make you take a vacation.
Those people, they're just like, I haven't taken a vacation in 10 years, but, you know, we used to get it on the cruise all the time. I'm here with my family. My kids have never told me they've loved me so many times in my life, because this is the first vacation that I have taken with them in X amount of years. And it's like, so they think, you know, I don't vacation, so DVC isn't for me. But DVC is going to make you take that vacation. So that's someone who, you know, I think a lot of times would think that it isn't for them, but we're like, okay, we need to have a therapy session right now. Like,
and you can break them.
We're going to have some hard truths. We're going to have some hard conversations right now. And just remember, at the end of the day, like, if it really is not for you, if you call up any DVC resale market guides, we don't want you to have this if it's not a good fit for you. Because guess what? You're going to be, you know, online, like, they sold me this thing and I never use it. We're going to be very transparent and very honest with you and get to know you and your family and your lifestyle and see if it's a good fit for you.
And you know what? There's three things that we hear from members all the time. We wished we had bought sooner. We wished we had bought more points. Best thing we ever did.
Yep.
And worst case scenario, if it's not the best thing you ever did, just call us back. We'll sell it for you. Or you can rent out your points. If, you know, I think that's a big concern for a lot of people too, is like, what if there's a year that I don't want to do Disney? Or there's always those, like, it's like 4 years where the kids go to college and they don't want to hang out with, you know, the family. And it's like, what do we do in those 4 years? There are other alternatives too. So I think it's really important to explore that. You know, you have banking and borrowing your points. So if you're not going to use the points 1 year, you can bank them into the next year. Do something huge the next year. Or if there is that gap, that 4 year gap or whatever, or you want to take an international trip that you wouldn't typically take, just rent your points out, and then that'll cover your dues for the year plus some.
One of the reasons I was most excited for this topic is I think if there's been one person in the 4 years that I've known him who has not expressed much interest in DVC, he is in this room today, and that would be Mr. Craig Williams. So I thought it would be fun to have Craig chime in on this topic a little bit. And Craig, I think we'll just start a little bit with just, you know, what is your overall impression of DVC, and why has it been something that you've not been that interested in?
Okay. First things first, we have to make very clear, I have a very strange job that sees me put up into hotel rooms a lot of my, you know, a lot of the time for absolutely no cost at all, because it's because of work. On top of that, too, media events where I'm given hotel rooms to stay on property. So I stay on Disney property quite a bit. It is 100% my work. And do I want to then invest in a place that brings me that I mostly associate with work anymore. Not really. I still find special moments with Disney, and I love Walt Disney World. I cannot get enough of it. That's why I continue to do this. But when I'm planning trips involved with Disney, it's on Disney Cruise Line, and it's to Disneyland. And we do know the challenges of DVC and Disneyland. Y'all talk about that enough. I know it'll probably get easier with the new tower at Disneyland Hotel. I thought maybe I could get involved with DVC because of that. But then I kind of backed off on that. And I said the same thing again with the cabins at Fort Wilderness, because that's the only place on property that I ever like doing staycations at. For my family, we have a dog that has seizures that needs medication a lot of the day. So it's not as easy as just like, oh, we'll stick him in the kennel for the weekend and go away, because we know that, you know, if something bad happens in the middle of the night, we're missing out on that. So we literally need to have someone's vacuuming outside, I believe. So we need to, like, we have to have everything in place so we can actually vacation the way we want to. You know, my family has to be taking care of everything. Now we have the new addition of a child in our family that makes life even more stressful. So staycations are something that we rarely ever got to do. And it's something that we still don't. I don't think we'll ever be able to do in the future. And then also to trying not to lose my train of thought with it, like, talk about disconnecting. Unfortunately, when you work for Pete Werner, that is not an option, and you are not allowed to do that unless you are on a cruise. And so for me, a cruise is still the best way that I can go on and be like, oops, I didn't buy the internet package. I'm so sorry. I actually can't be on my phone for that long, because if I have a cell phone connection, I'm expected to check in. Yep. So I'm in a very unique circumstance in terms of how I see Disney. And then beyond that, too, I shared with the group earlier that I'm really starting to move on, like, with how I'm traveling when I do get time to travel, with trying to hit national parks. And I am sometimes very, very thrifty with the deals I'm looking for with hotels and how to really stretch the dollar. And so when I add up everything, DVC just isn't something for me. Maybe one day, if grandkids are ever in the picture and do hear that story of you want to get all the family together, maybe go at it from that direction. But that's long into my future right now.
Yeah, it makes perfect sense as to why it's not beneficial to you now. You know, like you said, you know, you're at Disney always, you know, you're put up in rooms to review these rooms and stuff like that. It's just not something that makes sense to spend your own money on. But as you ended with, you know, who knows what the future brings you? Are you in Florida? Are you working related to the travel industry? You know, what does that future mean? And what does Disney then mean? Or what does Disney Vacation Club mean to you at that point? Amy and I are kind of in the same boat as you mentioned, which is that with our vacation, it's not that we don't still disconnect with DVC. I still think we do. I still love more than anything, like, taking a long weekend and doing that at a Disney Vacation Club property, because for me, some of my work gets, I get inspired to do some of it there. So you always find inspiration when you're like in the bubble, kind of, and that kind of stuff. But for that full disconnect, we just did an Alaskan cruise with Royal Caribbean. And now Amy has this dream of us becoming Diamond Platinum Plus members of the Royal Caribbean.
I mean, you get free drink vouchers. What else do you want?
There's no other reason to spend thousands upon thousands of dollars on cruises. But it's the same sort of thing. You know, we want to see more of the world. We want to see other things.
I mean, I know, too, you choose where you want to buy into DVC. And it's a lot easier when you do it resale and you can find the contract that's at the right price for everything that you want at the right resort. But I also don't like a lot of the DVC resort properties. Like, I don't like Bay Lake Tower. There is nothing about it besides Top of the World. There is nothing about it until they completely remodel that entire thing that I will never like it. Old Key West is my least favorite part of Walt Disney World property, and I know that always gets
like
me into a lot of trouble.
Yeah.
Old Key West reminds me of the very first apartment condo that I lived in all the way off of 27 in Davenport, because it has the exact same color scheme and looks almost the exact same from the outside. And it's just, it brings me nightmares of being my absolute poorest.
I thought you were just going to say you were a bad golfer.
No, I am a bad golfer too. But yeah, so like, I don't like that. Saratoga just doesn't vibe with me. Of course, I love everything at Wilderness Lodge. Polynesian, I've been lucky enough to stay in the DVC side multiple times and always enjoy it. Animal Kingdom Lodge, without a doubt. So there's ones that can get me, but then you stick me in like a Riviera and I'm like, I don't understand what people are seeing in this property because I hate it so much.
Now, you mentioned earlier the new cabin addition at Fort Wilderness being something that's appealing to you. What just sort of made that more interesting?
Because it is... I hate saying that Fort Wilderness isn't like being in Florida, because Orlando also isn't like being in Florida. You know, once you get far enough north or south or any direction, Florida all of a sudden has a very unique wildlife and just nature. And so actually Fort Wilderness is doing a good job of capturing what Florida is like outside of the Disney bubble in a way. And I love the cabin aesthetic. I love that, you know, you're right next to all your neighbors, but you also don't feel like you're on top of each other. You know, everyone can be sitting out on their patios having a cookout without feeling like you're encroaching on each other. And, you know, obviously riding around on golf carts around that property is always fun. So it in itself is just a great place to stay. And yeah, with DVC coming in and refreshing, that's the one thing that could like truly sell me on it, because the cabins, as much as I love them, they've also been very dated since the last refurb they went through. We live in a time period where we don't want things dark, and I don't want to say damp in that way too, but that's kind of how it is. Yep. They don't allow a lot of natural light in, and it's just not the most... It's a cabin experience, but it's not the most pleasant. Add in some natural light, like really make the interior something special, add more Disney touches in there. All of a sudden you could have like a premier property on hand. And that's something if I love it enough, I will go out of my way to say, no, I do want to stay here for a couple nights each year and make that my time where I say, no, I'm cutting off. Pete, please don't call me.
throw the phone in the lake. And go, I don't know what happened.
How did I get into airplane mode for all those days?
I don't know how to use this new phone or something like that. And to that point about Fort Wilderness that you made about sort of escaping Florida a little bit, that's something that Amy and I have said since we moved down here. And I know that we're kind of from the same neck of the woods almost, is that we didn't really appreciate, I think, Fort Wilderness or Wilderness Lodge as much as we do now that we are Floridians, because it does, even though it's Pacific Northwest, it's still pine trees. It kind of gives that feel of home for us, which makes me want to go back there. And so it's definitely, ever since we moved, you know, Copper Creek, Boulder Ridge, Fort Wilderness, all of that has moved significantly up in our interest list because it does give us those memories of home. Yeah.
It's the idea that you could walk out into trees and, you know, you only have to worry about deer, maybe like rattlesnakes every now and then. It's in Florida, that's completely different. It's like 100 different ways you can die just by walking into a wooded area.
Yeah.
If you are really savvy too, and you are one of those people, you know, you were kind of saying that you like the challenge of like finding a really good deal. I would encourage you also to start, like, if you do want to get your feet wet, start with a really small point package, like a 50 pointer. You obviously can't do that if you're buying direct, but if you buy resale, you could start with a really small point package. You could do just like a few nights here and there at Disney, or bank and borrow your points and do like a whole week. But I'd be really interested to see like what kind of trips you make out of that small point package. And then if it's a good fit for you, great. You add on, you know, when it's right for your life. And if not, you sell it. And those small point packages sell really quickly. I mean, within hours, most of the time.
True. And you know, it's interesting. Sometimes people also, it's very smart, you know, from a financial standpoint, to buy that small point package because mm-hmm. that's what you can afford. And I would much rather see a young couple buy a 50 or a 70 point package than not buy it all and right. continue to rent and pull money out of pocket or put the vacation on the credit card and it takes them a long time to pay it off. Put that money you're going to spend anyway, buy that small package, because you'd be amazed how many times over the years people would add on, okay, I'm going to buy another 50. Now I can afford another 100. And now it goes up and goes up. But to the topic of the day, I think, you know, Disney Vacation Club, who it belongs to, depends on the person and where they're at. And life changes. Life changes. Where you can do things when you're much longer, younger from a financial standpoint and get away from work and jobs and all that is different than that person I was describing that came in not to buy for himself, but buying for the kids and the grandkids and what we always call the family legacy.
And if you talk to anyone who has like 1,000 points now, I mean, like, look at Pete. Like, he didn't start with the number of points that he has now. Your life is going to change. And so, like, you know, don't get so caught up. I think that's one thing that a lot of people do is they'll look at that point package and, or that point chart, I should say, and you do. You start dreaming and you start planning and you're like, oh, well, if I had 200 points, I could do this or I could do this. But, and so you're like, okay, I need 400 points. It's like, you don't have to start there. Just get in. Even if it's 50 points, like, get in, see how your family is going to use it. See how creative you can get with those points. I mean, you'd be surprised how far a 50-point contract can take you. Like, you could get super creative with it, but just, like, get started. You don't have to start with an astronomical amount of points. That's the cool thing about DVC.
And it increases your quality of life. I mean, my gosh, look at, you know, 50 points. I believe it's 9 points a night in Jumbo House. Yeah. In a value studio. I just wish they'd call it Jumbo Studio. That makes more sense to me. But 9 points a night. 50 points in a room that's worth rack rate about $600 a night before room tax of 12 and a half.
Exactly.
So,
or you can do Aulani. You could do a week in Aulani with 50 points. Like, that's mind blowing. But if you're creative enough and you know, you're not going to go to Aulani every single year, but if you're creative enough, you can do a Hawaii dream vacation at Aulani with a 50-point package.
Yeah, so I think the bottom line is if you want to go to Disney, then you should definitely look at Disney Vacation Club, yeah. Right? It's definitely for the Disney fan that wants to go to Disney, that wants to stay at Aulani, Walt Disney World, Disneyland, where, you know, wherever. But if you're not going to Disney, Disney Vacation Club is most valuable being used at Disney Vacation Club resorts. So if you're not going
right
to those Disney Vacation Club resorts, then you might want to start thinking if DVC is for you.
Yeah, and I think the real thing I wanted to bring home with this topic was to really get the wheels spinning with those people that just dismiss Disney Vacation Club before they ever even think about it, before they ever even think about what it means, not necessarily to them, but Linda, to your point, to maybe their spouse, to maybe their kids. Craig, to your point, to grandkids potentially down the road. You don't know where life will take you, so, you know, thinking about the product in that more futuristic realm, potentially. I think that I kind of double down on what I say. It is for anyone that is within this Disney space and loves doing Disney or has family members that love doing Disney, loves being a part of Disney. I think that there is a time and place where it is for everyone. It's just whether or not that aligns with when you're potentially looking at purchasing that.
And when you want variety, too.
Yeah.
Because, you know, Disney's very, very important. It was founded by Walt Disney World. This was, I think, Walt Disney's dream that he didn't get to see. For families to be able to stay in homes in Disney. He didn't get to see that. And that's what Disney Vacation Club has created and evolved and has saved all this money. But don't forget those 3,200 other places that become important to people like me, the ski vacations, that I'll tell you what, you could go to Colorado and ski peak week in a one bedroom for 150 vacation, or 100, it's either 150 or 160 vacation points. You can't go stay in a one bedroom at Disney for peak week for 150.
That's peak, that's like New Year's.
That is the best time, busiest time. So don't, when you get tired of the theme park idea, just know that there's other life for you. There's that castle in Ireland you could go do. So it goes on and on.
I think another person, type of people, group of people, I should say, who I talk to them a lot, maybe initially think that DVC isn't for them and then actually end up joining are cast members. Because, you know, you get that cast discount. So you think, what do I need DVC for? I get this cast discount to stay at all of the properties. But anyone who's been a cast member for a long time also knows that you have that inflation piece. And so I get cast members all the time that will end up buying and they're like, I really should have done this a long time ago. If I would have known that even with my cast discount, it was going to be hundreds of dollars to stay at any of these Disney properties, I would have done it a lot sooner. So I thought that was interesting as well.
DVC is for everyone. come full circle. All right. I think that was great. Thank you, Craig, for sort of chiming in this week on the show. So I greatly appreciate that. I hope you all enjoyed it. And we will see you all with next week's DVC show.